Nearly 4 years ago, Cape Coral voters approved the Go Bond measure, allowing $60 million to be raised for park improvements across the city.
But with supply issues and pandemic pauses, the upgrades to Cape Coral parks have slowed down. NBC2 investigator Ashley Graham explains the present and future of these projects.
The plan for more and upgraded parks started in 2016.
Whether it was recreational, green space, we recognized that as a growing city, we needed more parks.
It came to fruition 2 years later when Cape Coral residents voted on the Go Bonds referendum.
We'd have them all done in 3 years for $60 million, and it would be done.
It would fund seven new parks and pay for updates to dozens of existing parks. We went around Cape Coral to check them out. There is work happening at some existing parks.
Great!
And the city did break ground on new ones last year. Of that $60 million, so far the city has spent just over $9 million. They plan to spend another $17 million on approved projects. The biggest chunk of that $60 million would go to the Cape Coral Yacht Club. But now, the price tag for all of those parks is going up.
How much more than $60 million are we talking?
Well, we don't know exactly yet until we get all the permitting, but we recognize that it's probably going to be anywhere from the $10 to $15 million more than anticipated.
It's not just money.
When the referendum was initially passed, it was supposed to take about 3 to 5 years to get that work done. Right now, we're in about year four, and as you can see behind me, there has been some work done on the local parks, but the majority of what's yet to be done is still tied up in permits, and right now the city says that timing is kind of out of their hands.
Of course, we have to have the permits in place before we can start construction.
The city did hold public input meetings in 2019 about plans for the seven neighborhood parks. Critics like Tom Shadrach argue that that process held up progress.
Let's go back and talk to the public, spend another year redesigning, rethinking what does the public really want. They've had some forums. So that took a year out of the schedule, in my view.
Do you feel that that three-year mark was too optimistic?
I thought the three-year timeline was probably a little aggressive, but I thought that 5 year was close to being attainable.
Mayor John Gunter says the permit issue is not the only factor.
I think some of the things that we didn't surely plan on as a pandemic, I think that really played in to this process.
Others say the work should have been done long before COVID-19 became an issue.
If they'd have finished everything in 3 years like the plan was, none of that would have been impacted. Today, now it's impacted huge.
We would have been out by 2020.
We would have been done by 21.
City leaders say they're working hard to get the parks done in time. City Council is currently deciding whether to take the Cape Coral Yacht Club out of the Go Bonds package and to use the entire $60 million on the remaining parks. When the permits are approved, they say they'll work quickly to start the remaining work.
We are moving forward. We will get these projects completed in a timely manner.
Reporting in Cape Coral for NBC2, I'm Ashley Graham.
Even though it's